This week's video is about preheat. It's probably one of the best features that all EV owners absolutely love about the car. Every EV owner will probably tell you it's their favourite feature, certainly in the winter. Please subscribe to my channel, by the way. It helps my channel grow and it gives me an indication that I should carry on making these videos. So there's a couple of ways to preheat the Zoe. The best way for me, and I find the most practical, is to plug the car in at home and you can use the preheat function built into the car. You press this little button here and that will load up this part called the comfort timer on the sat nav screen. You then select the time that you're going, you want the car to be ready. Now you can have two preset times for quick, easy use if you work shift patterns and you're waking up at different times of the day. So let's, for example, say we're going to want the car to be ready at 9 o'clock because we're leaving the house at 9 o'clock. You'd press that timer, or you can edit it and set your own time. The only annoying part is you have to set it at either 9, so you're dead on the hour, 15 minutes past the hour, 30 minutes past the hour, 45 minutes past the hour, or exactly on the hour. So that's the only annoying part, but let's just say you know you're definitely at 9, you want the car to be ready at 9, set it at 9, make sure it's highlighted, as it says, car must be plugged in for the comfort timer to work, press done, and then that's it. And you'll see that that light will stay illuminated, and then there's that bit on the dash there, which also says it's connected. So I'll just show you the bit on the dash. So you'll have that little symbol on the dash there, indicating that the comfort timer has been set. So the other way of preheating the car is pressing the button on the key fob, which is this one here with the picture of the wavy lines. You have to press it twice. First one will activate it. Second press will make the lights flash on the car and the preheat will start. So I'll just show you two ways of knowing it's preheating. One, the lights have lit up on the climate control, and then two, if I turn the microphone towards you, you'll hear the fans kicking. So the other way of doing it is using the Zeti Services app. So firstly, what you do is you load up Zeti Services on your phone, scroll down to preconditioning, and you can set a timer with the time that you want the car to preheat. Press set timer and that should send the request to the car. But the reason I don't like this one is it depends on a couple of things, and one is the mobile phone signal inside your car SIM card that's built into the car, and also that Zeti Services is working, which are both unreliable, so I don't like to use this one. You can also just tell the car to turn on by going down to this option here. It says turn on, say yes, and it will precondition the car straight away, in theory, if the SIM card is working. But like I said, it doesn't always work. It's not guaranteed. The two best ways of doing it are the two ways I've showed you before. My personal choice of preference is using plugging the car in and using the comfort timer built into the car, because you get it nice and toasty rather than just a boost of heat. The pre-schedule is the best way of doing it. If you've enjoyed this week's video, please subscribe, please like it, and please share it with your friends. If anyone you know wants an electric vehicle, let us know, leave a comment in the section below and I'll try and answer some questions. Thanks very much for watching, I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.